You know, Stephen, what we just watched is astonishing, all right? Why is the explosion of animal fossils on Earth in the Cambrian time period such a challenge to Darwin's theory of how life originated?
The abrupt appearance of animal life in the Cambrian period is really surprising for a couple of reasons. First, it takes such a small percentage of the total of geological history. There's so much innovation that takes place in such a small fraction of time that that's really unexpected. You'd expect on a Darwinian basis that you'd have the mechanism of natural selection, random mutation, gradually producing little incremental changes, and there'd be a kind of a steady increase in complexity over time. But instead, we see a very discontinuous or discrete increase, and that increase is confined to a very small percentage of geologic time. Now, we might be tempted to think, well, yeah, but still, that's the Cambrian explosion is roughly a 10 million year event. That's a lot of time. It's certainly a lot of time on the scale of human history. But what I think few of us realize or recognize is that that 10 million years is actually a blink of an eye biologically as well. It's a small amount of time in relation to the amount of time that the mutation natural selection mechanism needs to work. There's a branch of evolutionary theory known as population genetics, and it's a very mathematical branch of biology in which biologists are able to calculate what they call waiting times. This is the amount of time that you would expect for a given evolutionary change to take place. And biologists can make these calculations if they know something about the mutation rate, the generation time, the size of the populations of the different organisms that are involved. And recent calculations that have been made in the field of population genetics are showing that if you need more than a few coordinated mutations, the waiting times blow up beyond hundreds of millions of years. And so a 10 million year window is a blink of the eye biologically. It's not enough time even to generate a few coordinated mutations, let alone the origin of these extraordinarily complex animals. Trilobites, for example, had compound eyes that actually can be seen in the fossil remains of these animals. These are exquisitely complex forms of visual apparatus that are preserved in the fossil record, and they arise, again, very abruptly and within this 10-5 million year window. And this is really just not nearly enough time for natural selection mutation to do its work. So it's very surprising and a big challenge to the creative power of the natural selection mechanism.